Hi there. In our last section, you learned about different properties of determinants. In this section, you are going to learn how to use the properties of determinants to find the area of the triangle. So, let's begin. Area of a triangle. Let us consider a triangle with vertices A, x1, y1, B, x2, y2, and C, x3, y3. Then, the area of the triangle ABC is given as delta is equal to 1 over 2 determinant of x1, y1, 1, x2, y2, 1, x3, y3, 1. Basically, we find these values x1, y1 from the first coordinate, x1, y1 for point A, x2, y2 is the second coordinate for point B, and x3, y3 is the third coordinate for point C. In other words, we can say that if we want to find the area of a triangle, we need to plug in the value of the coordinates of the triangle in the determinant and solve it. Basically, this works as a formula for the area of a triangle using the determinant. If we simplify this determinant, we will get the area of the triangle delta equals to 1 over 2 x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. It does not matter along what row or column we expand the three order determinant, we will always get the same area for the triangle. There are a few points we need to remember before we go any further. So, first point, it does not matter what kind of coordinate we have, we will use the absolute value to find the area of the triangle because area of triangle cannot be a negative number. The second one we need to remember is that if the area of the triangle is 0, means delta is equal to 0, then the points are collinear.